Hello guys, and welcome back to Osiris Cloud with Mohammed. Today I'm going to make a video that was requested by several people on how to pass the AWS Solutions Architect Associate and my exam tips. Let's go. AWS Solutions Architect Associate is one of the most demand certifications and one of the highest salaries among IT professionals. So if you are looking to advance your career in IT, you are right to take that one. In this video, I will give you more details about this certification. We will also review what to study, where to begin, and the services you need to focus on. Based on Global Knowledge IT Skills and Salary Survey, the average salary for those holding the AWS Solution Architect Associate certification in the United States and in Canada is $113,000. But having the certification does not mean that your salary will grow instantaneously, but it can be an argument to renegotiate it. So this certification is intended for people who design cloud infrastructure or deploy systems and applications. You don't need to be an architect to take that one. If you are in IT and want to work in an AWS environment, you can take it. But AWS recommends at least 1 year of hands-on experience with deployment and management of AWS services. But it's just a recommendation. It's not mandatory. I have a friend who didn't know anything about AWS, but he worked hard for a couple of months and passed the exam. So it's possible. To be ready to pass the exam, you need to understand the global AWS infrastructure, understand network technologies as they relate to AWS, have the ability to identify which AWS services meet a given technical requirement. You need to be capable to identify and define technical requirements for AWS-based applications. You need to also understand security features and tools that AWS provides and how they relate to traditional services. So how can you prepare yourself to pass the exam? I will be honest to you, this exam will need hard work. It's not easy, so you have to focus on it a couple of months and make a schedule for revisions. If reading is not boring for you, you can start by buying this book, the AWS Official Study Guide. It will cost you $32 in Amazon. I will give you the link in the description. Honestly, if you really focus on this book, you will know everything you need to know to pass the exam, because this book covers all the exam objectives. And if you are more comfortable with video courses, you can take the AWS Solution Architect Associate course in Linux Academy, one of the leading in the cloud computing educational platforms. The course is really detailed, and you will have accessory materials that will allow you to schedule revisions and review the highlighted services that came out during the exam. They will also give you credentials to access the AWS platform and do some labs. When I took the exam, I did both. I learned with the Official Study Guide book and took also the courses in Linux Academy to make sure that I will not miss certain points. But it's still not enough to be totally ready to take the exam. You need to read FAQs for the key services that will come out during the exam, like VPCs. You can't pass the exam without knowing VPCs inside out. SQS, SNS, Simple Workflow, S3, IAM, DynamoDB, Lambda, Kinesis, CloudWatch, CloudTrail, EC2, EBS, ELB, Auto-Scalings, RDS, Route 53. If you read all this, even if it is in diagonal, you will be more comfortable, so I'll highly recommend it. I will put the FAQ links in the description. Now you are done with the learning path, you must test your knowledge by doing some practice tests. But I warn you to not trust all websites that offer leaked exam questions. Don't memorize the questions to base yourself on this to pass the exam. you will definitely miss out. Because at the time I'm recording this video, AWS has a strong knowledge base for exam questions, and they change all the time. But I have a good experience with a website called Whizlab.com. It's an e-learning platform, and they have questions that reflect the real exam questions and update them when new topics came out. This practice test for the Architect Associate will cost you $20. AWS provide also sample questions for the certification. I will give you in the description the link to directly download it. It's just 10 questions, but they will show you how the exam is going to be. When you have treated all the questions in Whizlab, is sure that you will be confident, you can now do the last step of your revisions to take the official practice test of AWS, which costs $20. You will pass it in the real platform of the exam. I recommend to take that one 2 days before taking the exam. And now you are ready to register for the exam. It will cost you $150, and it will be in multiple choices and multiple answer format. Questions are often long, but you can see short ones too. Just read them carefully and proceed by elimination if you don't have directly the answer. If you are not very confident with an answer, you have an option which allows you to flag the questions and review them later when you have time left. So that's it, guys. This was my recommendation to take the AWS Certified Solution Architect Associate. I hope it will help you to pass the exam. If you want to pass the AWS Security Specialty, you can click right here to watch my feedback video about this exam. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments or send me an email at osiris@osiriscloud.com. Don't forget to subscribe, and may the cloud be with you.